Hi everyone! This video shows the parts needed to build a PiAware, which is the software that runs on a computer receiving signals from aircraft. Signals are radio waves aircraft emit to tell any device listening where it is located every second. If you set up a device to listen to the messages and send the information to FlightAware, you can receive an enterprise account, a page showing the site statistics, and Skyview, which is a web page displaying live air traffic on a map. To get started setting up a PiAware, you'll need a computer running 24/7. Usually people run this on a Raspberry Pi, which is where the Pi part of PiAware comes from. While other computers can be used, we recommend a Raspberry Pi, which is what the software has been packaged to operate on. And for using other systems, you will need to seek out the information on the website or in the forum. When you purchase the Raspberry Pi, don't forget to either buy the power as a bundle with the Raspberry Pi or on its own because it does not come with the power connector by default. Try to pick a trusted brand like the Raspberry Pi brand or one that is a minimum of 5.1 volts and 2.5 amps. If the power supply does not meet those minimum specs, it will have trouble powering the USB dongle. You can also choose to buy a case for the Raspberry Pi. It is optional, but it can provide some protection from static electricity and make it look prettier. You will need to purchase the microSD card by itself or in a bundle with the Raspberry Pi. It is recommended to stick with a known brand and buy one that is 16 gigabytes. You can use one as small as 8 gigs, but sometimes it can cost more to buy in that size. Also, check to see if you have a microSD card reader or an SD card reader around the house. Most microSD cards come with a regular sized adapter, but you will need an SD card reader to connect that to a computer. Next, you will need to choose an RTL-SDR-USB adapter. RTL is the chipset used on the circuit board that helps translate the radio signal into a digital stream, and SDR is what happens when you combine it with software that decodes the signal, software-defined radio. Basically, the adapter takes the 1090 MHz radio signal received from the aircraft and converts it into a digital form for the computer. FlightAware makes two, but there are a few on the market. I'll be demonstrating with the ProStick Plus, the blue one, and the difference between it and the regular ProStick, the orange one, is that it has an onboard filter that helps with you in a radio noisy environment, such as a city. If you live in the country and there isn't much interference around you, consider using the ProStick. The RTL-SDR-USB adapters offered by FlightAware are slightly different from others on the market because they include an amplifier for the radio signal. I'll be using the ProStick Plus to demonstrate in later videos. If you choose a different RTL-SDR-USB adapter, be sure to confirm what connector it uses so your antenna cable will match. The last required item is a 1090 MHz antenna. You can choose to buy an indoor or outdoor version. This 1090 MHz indoor antenna is smaller and won't pick up as many aircraft, but will get your setup working at a lower cost. It also comes with a cable that ends in an SMA connector, which, if you're using a ProStick or ProStick Plus, will connect without any additional connection adapter. Optionally, you could purchase an indoor and outdoor antenna such as this 26-inch one that FlightAware sells, but it will cost more and you will have to purchase a cable. There are some recommendations for the cable type and length on the PiAware build optional page. If you're choosing to use a LAN connection instead of Wi-Fi, find a network cable around the house or buy one. Another option to consider is whether or not your setup needs a filter. The general rule is if you're in an urban environment, you will need one, and if you are in a rural environment, skip it. The filter is used to remove unwanted radio signal before reaching the dongle. If you are in an urban environment and know that you definitely need a filter, consider buying the ProStick Plus dongle that has a filter on board. In a very rare instance, using both the onboard filter in the ProStick Plus and the external filter can help with overloaded areas, such as being right next to a radio tower. Once you've found or purchased all the parts to build a PiAware, visit the PiAware build page on FlightAware.com for more information on how to put them together.